Let's see some characteristics of simulation in this particular module. Essential characteristic of simulation is imitation of reality. The entire environment is exploratory. Immediate feedback and reinforcement is expected. There is interactivity, adaptability. Simulations are learner-centered. Those are effective. Technology is needed for simulation. And there is provision of many variables. Let's see this particular simulation. Let's see this example. It's on demand and supply of various energy sources. So there is one hypothetical year 2010 and all these energy sources are provided. Now the learner is expected to adjust various sources, say oil, coal, gas, biofuel, hydro, nuclear, and the learner needs to manipulate its supply. You can see at the right hand there is a chart. There are two graphs about world energy and about atmospheric carbon dioxide also. You can see a pie graph also where all these ratios are shown. As soon as you manipulate, change any variable, all these graphs are going to change. So this actually tells you demand supply ratio and also its atmospheric carbon dioxide effect. This another simulation is example of ecology. It's about food web, and you can see that there are herbivorous animals, omnivorous plants, and you can increase and decrease their quantity, their ratio in the environment, and you will see what actually happens with a particular type of animal increases in the environment. So this shows you, trains you in many rules and values of ecology. Here's another fantastic simulation. You can see movement of Earth and Moon. You can even choose to select the movement of Sun and Earth, Sun, Earth and Moon. You can see the orbit. If you want to see velocity, you can see that the red arrow is velocity arrow. The pink one is the path. You may or may not add grid to it. You can even add gravity force to it. And you can see actual movements happening in the orbit with the context of gravity. So with the help of these examples, we can understand characteristics of simulation. You can see that this is imitation of reality. The entire universe is represented here and the entire environment is also represented. So simulation teaches various aspects of the real world by imitating it or replicating it. You can find out many solutions by changing variables in simulation. So basically learners can go on exploring and decide what will happen if I do this. What will happen if I reduce plants in the environment? And that's why simulations are learner-centered. Learners have absolute control over the package. And we can start and may leave at any time as per our will and wish. We can even save simulations if we are building something. For example, if it is a sim city or sim farm, then we can build that farm, save at a particular step, and then open it whenever we log in next time. Because learners are doing everything, simulation packages are interactive. Package includes activities, and this activity seeks quick and unambiguous response from the learner at every step. The learner's response is very clear, and learner gets to results to every response. The entire system changes as per the responses. So the learner has many controls. Learner can even decide what system or what kind of path the learner wants as per his or her own learning style, as per his or her own modalities. That's why even simulations are adaptive in nature. The adaptive system of simulation works with feedback. This feedback may be very natural feedback which happens along with progress in that particular simulation. These feedbacks may be artificial changes in the environment, sometimes immediate and sometimes delayed, wherever the result will be seen as the major final consequence. So all sorts of feedbacks can be planned in simulation mode. There is reinforcement along with every feedback. These reinforcement techniques may be very attractive in nature. Just see this simulation. It's how to bathe a baby. Now you can see that the baby is crying like anything. It's reinforcement given by that package. Because the tap may be open, the water may be overflowing, because the baby wants shampoo, or the baby is given excessive shampoo, in any circumstances, the baby will start crying. You can see happiness indexed on the right top corner. As soon as that happiness index goes down, baby starts crying. As soon as you take a positive measure, baby starts laughing. So simulated package even can provide clues for positive reinforcement. For example, you can see show hint button in the down corner, and there if you click, you will get hint how to make the baby smile. So it may have some clues, hints, helps, instructions for further explorations. Because this entire environment of simulation is multimedia environment, we can exploit all possible media elements. We can use animation, sound, video, graphics, 3D modeling to create environment and to give feedback, to give reinforcement. Here you can see entirely colorful environment where the learner can filter color and see effect of it. We can exploit technology such as internet, video conferencing, digital video, virtual reality to add effectiveness to the simulated system. There can be virtual labs also where many students of India and abroad can practice virtual practicals through these virtual labs. Many IITs of India have also created such virtual labs for our engineering and technology students. These are simulated environments. One of the major characteristics of simulation is variables. There are so many variables provided in simulation which can be controlled, manipulated by the learner. Now, how many variables should we have in a particular simulation? That is a crucial decision. Whichever variables are very significant and which will have direct impact on the outcome, all those variables should be provided. But there are many variables in reality. At the same time, so many things operate, so many parameters operate. If learner is thrown into a real-like environment where there are 50 parameters operating at the same time, the learner will get confused. The learner will not really learn effects of a few parameters. So in such cases, in simulation, we control some variables. We provide only crucial variables, or we even provide controls to the learner to limit parameters. So if at a particular point of time, learner wants to manipulate only three variables or two variables, we give that chance to the learner. So it's complexity simplified with the help of variables, and still effect of variables are shown to the learner. Thank you.